There's a lot at stake here. Between the ship and its cargo, we're talking billions of dollars, as well as the safety of every crew member on every ship. Ensuring that everyone and everything arrives safely at the next port is a heavy responsibility for the captain and crew. Once clear of inshore waters, there's not much between the ship and its destination, except weather.
Well, accurate weather forecasting is critical to the performance of our job. You know, I can't imagine doing our job of being a captain of a ship without accurate forecasting.
In the worldwide maritime community, time is money, and adverse weather can obstruct and delay voyages.
It most likely would affect the schedule. It may slow down the delivery of cargo. It certainly can make life very miserable for the people on board the ship.
But weather jeopardizes more than commerce. It also spells deadly disaster for a ship and its crew. For example, the El Faro, which sank during a 2015 hurricane.
The El Faro, in my account, was a very good ship, but it seems like the weather took the event on this case, and she had the worst. And again, this is a good reason why we need to pay attention to weather and respect the weather as it comes.
For the mariner, timely and accurate marine weather forecasts are crucial tools for voyage planning. Forecast meteorologists at agencies such as the National Weather Service are committed to making marine weather forecasts as reliable as possible. In order to do that, they need measurements of the ocean conditions. The measurements need to be accurate, timely, numerous, and they need to come from where the ships go, not just inshore, but also way offshore, where thousands of ships constantly traverse the high seas, vulnerable to hazardous weather. Weather buoys are a good source of the kind of data forecasters need, but buoys aren't everywhere. Buoys need to be cost-effectively anchored and serviced, so their placement is limited to near-shore positions. Satellites, from their vantage points hundreds to thousands of miles above the Earth, are another piece of the puzzle, delivering images of large-scale features such as hurricanes. But satellites don't tell us everything. Satellites are eyes in the sky. But some of the measurements forecasters need have to come from eyes on the surface.
Over the oceans, we have many large areas that we get no data. There's no data available in these areas because they're so large.
So, in the vast areas of the oceans where neither the buoys nor the satellites can give us what we need, how do we get it? The only way to determine precise, real-time sea level conditions offshore is from weather observations made aboard ships at sea.
The forecasters can't do anything without good weather observation at sea. It helps them. I mean, they've got satellites and all that, but that's not the same as a ship that's down there at sea level enjoying or suffering through the bad weather. That's critically important.
That's why the Voluntary Observing Ship Program, known as VOS, was established. Built on a concept of international maritime cooperation dating back to 1853, the VOS program recruits ships and provides training and guidance to crew members to voluntarily observe and report real-time weather conditions on all the world's oceans. VOS is about facilitating two-way communication from ship to shore and back to ship again of vital weather information that all ships need. It's teamwork. Each participating vessel becomes part of a vast, interconnected network of floating weather stations, collecting, reporting, and receiving weather data wherever they go. Weather prediction centers use the ship reports to supplement and validate data they receive from other sources.
This is better information than any other source that we could get it from. Receiving the information real time, the forecasters have the ability to see what's going on in areas that we normally do not have data for.
In areas where data is hard to come by, as little as one ship observation can verify or change a forecast over a great stretch of ocean, providing crucial advance warning for the next ship transiting through.
Looking at this chart, this is an Atlantic surface analysis chart. And this is where we identify all our surface features. This is a collection of observations from shore, land, some of them are buoy reports or ship reports within that area that are incorporated into the surface chart. So looking over the Atlantic, very large area, it appears by first look that there's many observations that we can do an accurate analysis of this chart. However, when we start to zoom in and we start to localize this map, take a look in the red circle. When we zoom in, we get off the coast of Florida, South Carolina, the Cape. This is a very heavy traffic area for shipping. However, there are no ship observations. I don't have any observations within that red circle. In fact, that's 780 miles off the coast of Florida and Cape Hatteras, all the way up to Cape Hatteras, of no information. Information that could be utilized to better analyze this area. I have ships all the time that ask me, I'm only one ship, what does my observation do? And for example, on this chart, if I put one more ship observation within that 780 miles, I would actually have a reason to reanalyze this chart and bring my line, my isobar over, which is actually going to reflect, if I were going to analyze this chart, perhaps a low pressure system developing in that area. And it would give a better heads up that something is in fact happening or could happen in the near future. And we all know, as forecasters, that off of Cape Hatteras, this is a very prime area for very explosive low pressure systems to develop. And one observation absolutely does make a big difference.
The VOS program contributes to better meteorological reporting and forecasting. And that information is transmitted to the ship, and those are read very carefully by the master and the mates on watch to help them plan their voyages.
Beyond their main role in developing weather forecasts, VOS observations are put to use in support of a number of other ongoing maritime needs. They're used in the production of marine pilot charts. Commercial routing services use them to plot the safest and most efficient courses for their ships. And VOS observations are also archived and analyzed by scientists conducting climate research. All of these products and endeavors interconnect in various ways to support worldwide shipping commerce and increase SOLAS, the safety of life at sea.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Rusty Alberall from National Weather Service, PMO.
In the United States, VOS is part of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA, and coordinated by port meteorological officers. It's one component of a larger international VOS program under the World Meteorological Organization. NOAA's VOS program generates over 400,000 ship reports a year. Collectively, all of the international VOS programs produce an average of 2 million ship reports a year. With 23 countries and over 3,300 ships currently participating, VOS is one of the largest observing programs in the world. The U.S. VOS program operates at no cost to the vessel or the shipping company. Observing instruments, reporting software, handbooks, and training materials are provided by NOAA.
We supply, at no charge, all equipment necessary to take a good weather observation. Barometers, temperature measuring devices, barographs to record that pressure trace over time. And we maintain all this equipment, and there's absolutely no charge to the ships.
The program is absolutely free. There's no charge to the ship, the shipping company, the agency, nothing at all. All costs are taken care of by NOAA.
And then it's just a matter of the mates on the ship taking the time while they're on watch to make the observation. And it's kind of like a job that they're supposed to do anyway.
The mates are there on watch, and typically for their shipping company, they're required to provide the weather observation, something that they're already doing. We are just asking that they package this information in our software and send it out.
So I don't think the VOS program is much of a burden on anybody. It's no additional burden, especially when you look at the benefit of it.
Let's look at how VOS operates aboard a participating ship. In addition to the many larger commercial vessels that take part in the VOS program, the Massachusetts Maritime Academy, with its vessel, the training ship Kennedy, not only participates in VOS, but port meteorological officers from NOAA provide training aboard the ship to the Academy's cadets in weather observation and reporting procedures. Ideally, VOS observations are made and transmitted every 6 hours, or 4 times per day, at designated time intervals known as synoptic hours. 0100 hours, 0600, 1200, and 1800 hours Greenwich Mean Time, also known as Coordinated Universal or Zulu Time. When vessels are within 200 miles of the U.S. coast or within 300 miles of a named tropical cyclone, they are urged to report every 3 hours. From the collection of observations to the transmission of the data, each report takes between 10 to 20 minutes to complete. VOS observers schedule the collection and reporting of their data so that they can be transmitting it at the top of the synoptic hour, when such reports are the most beneficial to weather forecasters. Among other observations, a VOS weather report includes such measurements as air temperature, sea temperature, wind speed and direction, sea state, visibility, and barometric pressure. To make the forecast as reliable as possible, accuracy and timeliness are key ingredients. The National Weather Service needs to know the real conditions that are happening right now. The better the data coming from the ships, the better the forecasts going to the ships. As one ship travels alone, it has a continuous opportunity, wherever it is, whenever it's there, to serve as the meteorological eyes of the world.
We are able to get real-time data as it's happening out over open ocean areas.
It's good for everybody. It saves lives and cargo and ships.
The better the observations, the more accurate they are, the better the end product, the better the forecast they get, the better planning they can do. So all in all, I mean, it's going to save them money, it's going to save lives.
A ship that participates in VOS gets a direct benefit. It may be invisible, but it's a direct benefit in having more accurate forecasting transmitted from the meteorologist ashore and received by the ship. So it's maybe it seems a little intangible, but it's real.
Over the world's oceans, ships from different countries go different ways for different reasons. But when it comes to the weather, we're all in the same boat, exposed to the same hazards. And when it comes to weather forecasts, VOS helps keep us all on the same page. Its never-ending cooperative process of collection, analysis, and dissemination informs our decisions and supports the safety and well-being of all those who go down to the sea in ships.